We often look at other people and we feel that our lives are so difficult and their lives have been so easy. We have had so many failures in life and their life has been a cakewalk with all the successes coming up front or in a jiffy. But it is not so. Every person has his or her own fights. Every person has his or her own share of successes. But along with that comes his or her own shares of failures as well. To give you an example, I will be sharing with you the failures that I have faced in my entire life. So if I start with my schooling, when I was a kid, I always wanted to be a fighter pilot. I wanted to be in the Air Force. However, because of medical reasons, I could not join the Air Force. And at that point of time, I was not in a mood or I was not enthusiastic about joining the army or joining the navy. I had no idea about anything else related to the defense forces. I was just focused on joining the Air Force. So that was my first failure in life. I did not know what else to do, but I had to come out of my military school and try different things. When I came out, I decided that I want to do law. Out of nowhere, it just came to me. It was just an intuition. I had no idea what lawyers do. I had no idea what anyone else is doing in the world. And therefore, I just thought I'll be a lawyer. That was it. So I decided that I worked towards it in my 11th and 12th. I also worked towards my board examinations. Unfortunately, or we can say fortunately, I got very high marks in my boards. However, I did not get such a good rank in my law examinations. And therefore, at that time, I decided that I'll probably skip law or do it later after 3 years of graduation, but I'll probably move towards graduation at this point of time. So that was my second failure. Now, after that, when I did my graduation, I had no idea what to do next. I was thinking about law, but at the same time, I was also thinking about getting a job and starting to work. And that was when I decided that I'll give UPSC a chance. And therefore, I started preparing for UPSC in my third year. I gave my first attempt at UPSC in 2012, if I'm not wrong, yes. And that was a failure, a deep failure, I can say, because I reached the interview round in my first attempt. I was very confident about getting selected and I did not get any rank, not only IAS, but any rank. Therefore, it was a big shocker to me. That was my third failure, major failure. After that, I decided to prepare again, to go all out again. In 2013, I gave the examination. I did not clear mains in 2013. So a step down, normally UPSC, you step up, you clear prelims, then you clear mains, then you clear the interview. But then in first round or first attempt, I cleared the mains and went to the interview. But in my second attempt, I could not clear mains itself. That was when I decided to start writing RBI as well. Okay, so that was my fourth failure. And after that, I wrote RBI and I wrote UPSC again. So in my third attempt at UPSC, I cleared the mains again. I went till the interview round. And in this attempt, I had my brother also preparing alongside. So both of us had our interviews on the same day. And it is a very memorable event or an activity or an event, not an activity. So we went for the interview together. We did well. But again, my brother got a rank. He also did not clear IAS in his first attempt. That was his first attempt. He got a rank in postal accounts, I believe. And I did not get a rank again. So I was again out of the race. So that was my third attempt at UPSC. Simultaneously, I had started writing RBI then. In my first attempt at RBI, I went till the interview round. Then I decided in 2014 that I want to write other exams and I want to do my MCOM as well. So failures after failures after failures from 2012 or 2011, you can say, till 2014 going on. Then I wrote my DSE, Delhi School of Economics examination, and I cleared that. So that was one big success after a lot of failures. And I started doing my MCOM. Simultaneously, I got selected in SBI. I went to Mumbai, joined SBI as a probationary officer, did not like it, left it after a brief stint of 3 months, came back, decided to pursue or carry on with my master's and simultaneously keep writing RBI and UPSC. But then I ultimately dropped UPSC after my third attempt. I decided I don't want to do it at this point of time. I want to focus probably on my master's and RBI. So I wrote three attempts at RBI, reached the interview round in all the three, and missed all the three interviews. After interviews, I did not get selected. In my final attempt, I missed the final cutoff by 0.25 marks. I remember it clearly. And simultaneously, I was pursuing my MCOM, my master's, and I was also teaching simultaneously in my college itself. A lot of fellow colleagues, a lot of juniors, I had started teaching just for fun. So I was doing it in college, doing it in the canteen, doing it anywhere and everywhere I could find people and teach them. So that was when I started teaching people, teaching students online for RBI specifically in January 2016. So till this time, I had been failing miserably. Three RBI attempts, failed after the interview, coming so close to the final selection. Two UPSC interviews, failed. Got selected in SBI, a smaller success for me at that time. Got selected in DSC, a big success, a very major success for me at that time. But failures before that as well in my law, never went around to do law. Oh yes, now I remember, more failures. So I got selected in CLC, Campus Law Center, if I'm not pronouncing it incorrectly. And I got selected there thrice, if I'm not wrong. And I joined all the three times. I thought I'll do law, but I dropped out all the three times. So that is another failure on my part, not a failure with respect to getting selected, but a failure because I did not complete my law, and I've still not become a lawyer. I've still not completed my law. It's still a work in progress. So another set of failures there as well. So failures, what I want to say, are a part and parcel of life. Value your own failures, but at the same time, do not think that other people don't have any. Other people have had similar or same intensity of failures as you have had, in some different avatar probably. Okay, every person has a unique life. Every person has a unique dimension or a unique face of a failure. For me, it was like this. For you, it must have been, and it must be, in some other avatar, in some other face. So value your failures, take them seriously, learn from them. Think that these failures are going to help you succeed in some or the other way in the future. By success, we mean anything that makes you happy. That is what success is all to me. So keep valuing your failure. Do not think that other people are getting anything and everything on a platter. They're also going through their own struggles, their own failures, and therefore everyone should be empathetic towards each other's lives. I'm very sure after this small discussion, you're going to be more patient with your life. You're going to be more inward looking towards your failures and successes, and you will be more focused towards your future successes in life. All the very best. Take care.